The question is, which one is better? The DIY banana peel tea or the chemical fertilizer for the orchids? That's a really good question. But today, I will show you guys which one that works best for me. Enjoy this video. Hello everyone, welcome back. This is Lovelyn again. So today, I want to show you guys the fertilizer that I use for my Vanda. I've been using it for 6 weeks, and my banana tea that I use for my Phalaenopsis and Cymbidium and Onsodium. So we will compare based on my experience and result. So this is the three items that I use for my Vanda. Why I use this item for my Vanda? Because the other one is sick and yellow leaves, and it's just not healthy looking. So I search about it, and there's a soak that somebody in YouTube that made, and it works for her. So, but it's a lot of work. But I've been using this Orchids Plus, the Calmag, and Seaweed Extract. So these three things, I put in 1 gallon of water and soak my Vandas, 6 of them, for 24 hours. And then once it's emptied after 24 hours, then I'm gonna use Calmag, 20 drops in a gallon of water and soak that one. And then after that, so I use these Orchids Plus 20-14-13 half a teaspoon, and soak my Vanda for 24 hours and spray some in their leaves. And then after that, I will put all three again in a gallon of water and soak it. So alternate those three techniques every week, like every other day, and then you know, switch back and forth. For me, it's a lot of work, especially when I work full-time and then taking care of my orchids. I don't really like it. So I've been doing these techniques for 6 weeks now, and you know, the only I have the result of all this hard work, I'll show you guys. Result that I seen with my chemical fertilizer are the roots. So look at the roots. So I got two roots coming out, a new leaf. All right guys, so with the fertilizer, chemical fertilizer that I use for my Vanda and the banana tea, I got lots of result from the banana peel tea that I made. I use it for 8 weeks now, so, and it's easy, quick, and I use it once a week or every other week or twice. I just spray it twice for my semi water culture and full water culture. If I mess the fertilizer, because when I fertilize them, I soak them for 30 minutes. But if I don't have time to soak them for 30 minutes, so I just put them in the bottle, spray bottle. Put them in the spray bottle, spray them in the morning, quick spray, twice a week. That's all I do, and that's done. And then when the weekend come, and if I have time, then I can change the water and everything. So I did some research about banana. So banana is a really good food for human, you know, because as I mentioned before, they are full of potassium, magnesium, and phosphorus. But the banana peel is more loaded of those elements than the fruit. I don't know how true is that, my research. So anyway, the banana peel, they call it a superfood for the plants. So that's really awesome that the banana peel is a superfood. And then if you make a tea out of it, so the way I do it, cut it in small pieces, soak it for 24 hours and use it for my plants or orchids, then it helps promote the healthy cycle
for your orchids or plants. So potassium carries the plants to blooms and promote buds. So that's a really good thing. So if you want your orchids to bloom, then banana peel tea will be a good thing, because the more potassium, it promotes blooms and buds. So that's awesome to prevent disease. And I found out few months ago, I think last year, I got the aphids war. I don't know what to do. I use water, alcohol, and soap, dishwashing soap. And they're good for a week, and then they come back again. And then this time that I've been using banana peel, I did not see any aphids at all. I don't know why. I don't see any aphids. And you know what? I found out in my research that aphids don't like the smell of the ripe banana. So the banana peel tea works for aphids too. I'm gonna use that for my roses and tomatoes when my garden is done. So we'll see how it goes. But nowadays, it works for my orchids. The aphids is gone. My orchids are happy. I'm very happy about that. So I'm gonna continue using the banana peel tea. So with all that being said, for me, because I don't like chemical, that's the thing I mentioned in my several videos, I like more DIY organic fertilizer. So banana peel tea for me in my lifestyle, it's quick and easy, and my orchids are happy. They give me a lot of, you know, blooms, buds, spikes, roots, and leaves, and I'm very happy about that. So if they are happy, these are happy, so I'm happy. So chemical fertilizer versus banana tea in my lifestyle, I love banana tea. I like banana tea, and I'm gonna use my banana tea to my plants outside, to my flower bed, to my vegetable garden, and the most thing is the roses. When I got my roses bed finished, I'm gonna use that banana peel. You can crumble it, spray it to the roses bed. Banana peel or the banana is loaded with all these nutrients that our plants needed, especially the orchids. They love the potassium. So that's the thing I'm gonna do, guys. I, in my own experience and my lifestyle, banana tea is my best option. All right, guys, if you like this video, please thumbs up and subscribe below. Please subscribe below and click that bell that says all, so you don't miss any of my video. All right, guys, thank you for watching and thank you for your time. I'll see you in my next video.